In this lecture, we will verify the condition of exact differential equation, that is ordinary differential equation. The verification of the condition is such that partial derivatives m with respect to y is equal to n with respect to x in the differential equation, that is m dx plus n dy is equal to 0. In this case, let m x comma y dx plus n x comma y dy equal to 0. Here del m del divided by del y is equal to del n divided by del x. This is the condition, required condition to be verified for exact differential equation. Let me take an example here. This is the problem, set of problems which I am discussing today, mixed type of problems, exact, non-exact, and the rules to find out the integrating factor in the case of non-exact differential equation, that is nothing but reducing the non-exact to the exact differential equation. Okay, so let me write an example here. That is dy by dx plus of y cross x plus sin y plus y divided by sin x plus of x cross y plus x equal to 0. This is our required condition for verification of exact differential equation. Here, this is the differential equation not appear exactly according to this type. That is, m dx plus n dy equal to 0. You arrange this differential equation in that type of terms, like m is multiplied to dx and n is multiplied to dy. Now, if you write this differential equation to other side, that means one term to other side, dy by dx and equal to minus of, it is y cos x and plus sin y plus of y divided by sin x plus x cos y and plus of x is there. I will take the cross multiplication and writing all terms to one side, dx, that means this is the term, I will write all the terms to one side, that should be y cos x plus of sin y and plus y is multiplied by dx and minus of sin x plus of x cos y plus of x into it is dy equal to 0. This is what the differential equation we have. Now, this is exactly according to the standard form, like m of x comma y dx plus n of x comma y dy equal to 0. Then m value is this much and n value is this much. If you take this along with minus sign, because here plus sign is there, therefore let m x comma y equal to y cos x and plus of sin y and this is plus of y is there. Then what is the differentiation? Del m divided by del y. So del m divided by del y takes the meaning you have to differentiate m with respect to y, keeping x as constant. Here this is conveying the meaning x to be taken as temporarily constant. X to be taken as temporarily constant, that is with respect to y equal to cos x plus of cos y and plus of 1. This is with respect to y only. Cos x is constant as it is. With respect to y means that is 1 and sin y, differentiation gives cos y, and this is nothing but plus 1. Okay, so writing all terms to one side means that is minus of this one. Okay, taking cross multiplication here I did, this is dy, and dx is multiplied to all these three terms and shifted to the other side. That means y cos x plus sin y plus y multiplied to minus sign, and I took it to the another side. Then this is also cross multiplied. Okay, and then this is nothing but dy by dx is equal to total this quantity, taking cross multiplication, and one term that becomes plus sign here. Okay, so this is y, and dx term, all the terms we are writing to the other side. Therefore, this is totally value of m. And similarly, value of m you have to choose. Let n is equal to means n of x comma y, that is sin x, sin x plus of x cos y and plus of x is that. Okay, then this is to be differentiated del n divided by del x. In this case, y is, it is constant. So with respect to x means it is cos x, where y is constant, cos y, only with respect to x is 1 and plus of 1 is there. So del m by del y is cos x plus cos y plus 1, and del m by del x is equal to cos x plus cos y plus of 1. If you take this one, that is equation number 3, and this is equation number 1, sorry, 2, and this equation as equation number 1. From 1 and 2, we have del m by del y is equal to del m by del x. That means both the values are same. Cos x plus cos y plus of 1 is there. And here also cos x plus cos y plus 1 is there. Therefore, so we have both the values same. Therefore, condition for exact differential equation is satisfied. Condition for exact differential equation is nothing but that is these two derivatives must be equal. Accordingly, we have these two values. So now, what is the solution? We have to write the solution of this differential equation. Therefore, equation 1, equation means ODE, ordinary differential equation, is said to be exact ODE. Is said to be exact ODE. Then the solution of 1 is given by that is m. M is this one, that is integration of y cos x plus of sin y plus of y, and it is dx. Here y is constant, plus integration of terms not containing x. It is dy is equal to constant. This is what the solution procedure. When once we say that the given differential equation is said to be exact, then we write the values of m and n separately. Then we will check the condition, this one. If this is verified, if this is mapping, that is we say that exact ODE. The given differential equation, we will say that
It is called exact differential equation.
Then the solution will be integrate every term, but m, where we treat this y as constant, but in the case of nx1, we have to choose the terms not containing x, that is with respect to y, that is equal to constant. Okay, so what is the integration with respect to x? Here y cos x is there, it should be y into sin x, integration of cos x is sin x, and sin y with respect to x means plus of x into sin y, because sin y is constant and our symbol x is due to integration of dx. Then plus another term, plus of xy, and that is third term, and plus of terms not containing x in n. In n, terms not containing x means no term is there. All the three terms, because n is representing three terms, but in all the three terms, x is present. Therefore, we don't find any term which is free from x. Therefore, that should be containing, not containing x means it is zero, integration of zero into dy, that is equal to constant. Then finally we have y sine x and plus of x into sine y and plus of xy and plus of zero, that is c1, is equal to constant. So these two constants you can club, and then finally you can write like this: y sine x and plus of x sine y and plus of xy and equal to, it is c2, some another constant you can write, where c2 is equal to c minus c1. So this is what the value. Hope these steps are clear. Let me repeat. The given problem is said to be exact, then these two values must be verified, and separately you choose n value and separately you choose m value, and the solution procedure is integration of m with respect to x keeping y as constant plus n. In that n you have to choose terms not containing x, and then that is dy, and it is equal to constant c. So this is what the solution. Let me repeat another problem on the same topic, that is under exact differential equation. Once again, same type of condition will be checked. That condition is to be verified for exact or non-exact type. If this condition is not satisfied, then we will say that it is not said to be exact differential equation. I will choose one more problem on this.
Sin x cos y plus e to the power 2x, it is dx, and plus of cos y, cos x cos y, and plus tan y, it is dy, equal to 0. We'll follow the same type of steps here also. First of all, you identify what is the value of m, terms representing for the value of m and terms representing for value of n. After that, you differentiate m with respect to y, keeping x as constant, and you differentiate n with respect to x, keeping y as constant. Now, in the solution, let m dx means m of x comma y dx plus n of x comma y, it is dy, equal to 0. Here
You can name this equation as 1 here. Let m x comma y is equal to sin x into cos y plus e to the power it is 2x. Then del m divided by del y with respect to y means sin x becomes constant. With respect to y, differentiation is minus of sin x and sin y, and with respect to y means this becomes 0. And n of x comma y is equal to cos x into cos y plus it is tan y. Then we are to differentiate del n by it is del x.
Here we keep y as constant, only we differentiate that term with respect to x.
Therefore, cos x differentiation is minus of sin x. Differentiation of cos x with respect to x, that is sin x with minus, and cos y, sin x cos y, del n by del x we are taking, it is cos x cos y, then and with respect to x means that is 0. Here sin x cos y, sin x cos y is 1, sin x cos y with minus, and sin minus sin x cos y. This also is said to be exact. Therefore, del m by del y is equal to, it is del n divided by del x. The equation is said to be, here also it is said to be exact. So when once it is said to be exact,
then we will try for the solution. As usual, the integration of every term we have to do that.
So this implies ODE, ODE 1 is exact. When the condition is satisfied, we will write that it is said to be exact. Then the solution is given by, the solution is given by, that is integration of sin x into cos y plus e to the power 2x, it should be dx. Here y is constant, plus of integration of cos x cos y, cos x cos y plus of tan y into dy is equal to, it is constant. Here terms not contain x, terms not containing x means this term is containing x, therefore we don't consider for integration, because integration of second term should be free from the term x. Therefore we consider the integration of every term according to the guidelines given. Therefore first one, with respect to x we are doing integration and keeping y as constant. Cos y is constant, sin x integration is, that is minus of cos x into cos y, into cos y plus with respect to x means e to the power 2x and divided by 2 integration, and plus of with respect to y terms free from x, this is not containing x. Therefore, tan y means integration, sin y divided by, it is cos y, it should be dy is equal to constant. So, minus cos x into cos y and plus e to the power 2x and divided by 2, and that is plus of integration of this, that is the formula you have. Differentiation of denominator if it appears in numerator, that is f of x in the denominator dx is equal to log of denominator. that is log of
denominator means integration of f dash x divided by f of x,
ratio of that under the integral sign is equal to log of f of x. Accordingly, cos y differentiation is minus sin y. So that minus is not there. So minus 1 I will write, and log of it is cos y, log of cos y, that is equal to constant. Then minus cos x into cos y plus e to the power 2x divided by 2, and minus, that is minus means plus, log of cos y. Log of cos y to the power minus 1 is equal to constant, because log m whole to the power n is there. That we can write. And simplification, that is minus of cos x into cos y plus e to the power 2x and divided by 2, and plus of log of, this is 1 by cos y, it should be secant y is equal to constant. So this is what the solution for the exact differential equation. So when once we say that it is non-exact differential equation, means this condition is not going to be satisfied. Let us verify in that case how the non-exact differential equation is verified with the condition that those two derivatives are not equal. I will check that. So, next problem I will take on non-exact differential equation. Example of non-exact or reducible to exact non-exact ODE.
Here we have four rules of identifying or converting or finding the integrating factor in order to reduce from the non-exact form to the exact form. Now, the first condition I will take, that means first there are four conditions. So, all the four conditions, every condition I will take the problem. That is first condition I will do that.
Example, solve 4xy plus of 3y square minus x dx and plus of x plus 2y into dy equal to 0. Let us verify
whether both the derivatives are going to match or not going to match. So, if both the derivatives are going to match, we say that it is exact, but if it is not going to match, we say that non-exact differential equation.
Okay. In the solution, this is exactly like m dx plus of n dy equal to 0.
So, we will check that this comes in which type of four rules already we discussed in our previous lectures. We will verify this problem comes in which type and how the integrating factor is to be calculated in order to convert the non-exact form into the exact differential equation.
Therefore, let m x comma y is equal to 4xy plus 3y square minus x. Then this implies del n y, it is del y.
So, for exactness, we have to check the condition del m by del y is not equal to del n by del x. If it is not equal, then we will declare that differential equation is said to be that is non-exact differential equation.
Therefore, del m by del y is equal to, in this case, x is constant with respect to y, that is 4x with respect to y, and plus of 6y is that. Okay, and then we will take that this one. The next is del n by del x. That means n x comma y is equal to x plus it is 2y. This implies it is del n by del x is equal to 1. So with respect to x is 1. Here it is with respect to y. Then we will do that del m divided by del y is not equal to del m by it is del x. Okay, that is x plus 2y is we are taking only x differentiation as 1. Therefore, 4x that is not equal implies this. If you say that equation 1, that equation 1 is set to be non-exact ODE. Then let difference you take del m divided by del y minus of del m by del x is equal to 4x plus 6y. 4x plus 6y, this value, and minus of 1. Okay, then here 3y square. This is 4x plus 6y minus 1 is there. Actually, this is y square is there respect to. Then this is multiplied by x. Actually, this is multiplied by x. And here that is 4x plus 6y into x is there. Okay, into x is there. Now, so this is 4x plus 6xy minus 1 and is not going to match with this. Let us verify, that is x if you take outside, that is 4y, here 4x, here 3y square and x plus 2y. So this value is not going to divide either this value or this value. Okay, so then this will be not coming in those four rules. That means you can write as 1 by m into, that is mx plus n into y, and 1 by n into mx plus n into y. So that this does not match with the rules what we have taken, so that we can find using another rule where we have to find out the integrating factor. So we will discuss in another case where we are going to apply that condition. So I will choose another problem. On the same type of calculation, I will take one more problem. Solve three x square, that is y, and plus of, that is dx, and plus of y to the power of 4 minus x cube, that is dy, equal to 0. Solution.
So we are verifying only, we are not doing the solution later using non-exact differential equation condition.
Okay. Let m x y, it is 3y into x square and 3 y into x square, therefore del m by del y is equal to 3 times x square, and n x comma y is equal to,
because we are discussing only the difference between these two values, another two rules later I will discuss. That means only two conditions are on the two applications means del m by del y minus of del n by del x. You must get either function of x alone or function of y alone. Only on that case I am writing the problem. Now,
n x comma y is equal to y to the power of 4 minus of, that is this one is minus, it is 3 x power. Sorry. This is x cube, that implies differentiation del n by del x is equal to minus of 3 x square. So now we will take down anyway these two values are not same. That means del m divided by del y is not equal to del n divided by del x. Implies this equation 1 is non-exact ODE. Then let the difference non-exact ODE, let the difference, because I am checking the difference, let the difference between del m by del y minus del n by it is del x, as that should be del m divided by del y minus of del n by del x is equal to 3 x square minus of minus 3 x square. This becomes 6 times x square. Now 6 times x square means without this can be divided with respect to the denominator as m value, or if you take this value, denominator as n value, so that accordingly on the right side you must get function of x alone or function of y alone. Then we need to calculate the corresponding integrating factor in that type. So we will check it. That is, it is 6x square. Here also x square is there. This is difference between two terms which will not support us, but this is the product of two terms which may support us to remove x square. Therefore, that is 1 divided by m into del m divided by del y minus of, it is del n by del x should be 1 divided by 3 x square y into 6, it is x square. Then 3 2s are 6 and x square cancels. This becomes, it is 2 divided by y. So when m is divided to the difference, del m by del y minus del n by del x value, when m is divided, so right side we expect in the absence of x. If n is divided, in the right side we expect in the absence of y. Therefore we call it as function of y and function of x. So now this we can call it as f of y only, right? That is f of y only, so that we will write according to that, when it is with respect to y, then the corresponding integrating factor is taken as, implies the integrating factor, is given by what? For we calculate the integrating factor to reduce non-exact differential equation into exact differential equation. That is IF equal to e to the power integration with minus sign. That is, this is called f of y into dy. Okay. For f of x dx, you will be getting plus sign, and e to the power minus, if you write, that is with respect to m division, for the difference of del m by del y minus del n by del x. Okay. Then according to this, we are going to consider e to the power minus integration, it is 2 divided by y, it is dy, e to the power minus 2 times of, it is log y, equal to e to the power log of, this should be y to the power minus 2. Answer is y to the power minus 2. Otherwise, 1 divided by, it is y square.
So, 1 divided by y square,
this value, that is y to the power minus 2 you have. Otherwise, it is 1 divided by minus 2.
1 divided by y square will be the final value. Now, if you multiply this value to the given equation 1, we claim that that differential equation, which was declared as non-exact, and it will be converted into exact differential equation. Then,
we will multiply that. But to this one, we will multiply y to the power minus 2. So, multiply by integrating factor, multiply by I of 2 equation 1, so that it becomes, exact, it is ODE. So, it becomes exact ODE when we say that, that is 1 by y square or y to the power minus 2, because I here is equal to y to the power, it is minus 2, or 1 by, it is y square. Therefore, 3y into x square divided by y square dx plus of y to the power of 4 by y square minus of x cube by, it is y square, and dy, that is equal to 0. So now we can check that whether this becomes exact differential equation or not after some simplifications. Let us simplify this. Here, y by y square should be 3x square by y square into dx, and plus of, this should be y square, and minus of x cube divided by y square, and that is dy equal to 0. Then here m is equal to 3x square divided by y. M is equal to 3x square divided by y means this implies del m by del y. Because we need to check, after multiplying the integrating factor, theory says non-exact differential equation becomes exact differential equation. So we will check the condition accordingly. That is del m by del y equal to 3x square divided by y means with respect to y, that must be minus of 3x square and divided by y to the power 2. This is the differentiation with respect to y. That means y to the power minus 1, and the differentiation y with respect to then y to the power minus 1 means minus 1 into y to the power minus 1 minus 1. That becomes minus 2. Then the same power I bring it to the denominator. Then n. So, n means n of x y, this term. So, that is y square minus x cube divided by y square. This implies del n by, it is del x. Only first term is 0, second term gives the differentiation, it is 3x square and divided by y square. Then, so this becomes del m divided by del y equal to del n divided by, it is del x, implies equation 1 is exact. Now it becomes the exact ODE. It becomes the exact ODE after satisfying the required condition del m by del y is equal to del n by del x. So that it is easy to write the solution with the same type of steps, integrating every term. And then that every term will be taken first term in the absence of keeping y as constant, and second term in the absence of terms containing x. Let us do that. So when once this becomes the That is equation number 2. If you write this one, we have to write the solution of this differential equation. Solution is given by integration, that is 3x square divided by y, it is dx. In this case, y is constant and terms not containing x. So directly I will be choosing plus of only y square, you have to choose, that should be dy is equal to constant. That means 3x square divided by y, in this case you have to treat y as constant and then you have to take x as variable. And in the second case, terms free from x you have to choose. Okay, what is the integration now for this? Accordingly, the integration you have to write with respect to x. This must be 3x cube divided by, it is 3y, and plus y square, it is y cube divided by 3 is equal to constant. Then, so this 3 cancels, otherwise 3c you can write on the right side. So 3x cube y square, sorry, y, and plus of y cube, and that is equal to 3c. This is the final solution of the problem.
When it is divided with respect to m, the difference is divided with respect to m, so that you will be writing the corresponding value where the difference is taken depending on how it is going to be allowed, whether m is going to be allowed to give the function of x alone or function of y alone. Let me take another example of that type.
Solve x cube plus y cube plus 6x dx and plus y square x and dy equal to 0. At x equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. Here
one condition is given to you. What is that condition? Some value of x and some value of y is given. So that helps us to calculate the value of the constant with the help of those given values, that is x and y. We call such values as initial condition. So initial condition will help us to find out the value of the arbitrary constant or constant of integration.
Already this problem is discussed, but the condition is different. Now we have to solve accordingly. We have to apply this condition and then we have to solve the differential equation. Therefore, let m x comma y is equal to x cube plus y cube plus of 6x. Then this implies del m divided by del y. Only with respect to y, it is 3, it is y square. Okay, and n x comma y is equal to y square, x is there. Okay, this implies del n divided by del x is equal to, with respect to x means this should be y square. Then here 3 y square is there, here y square is there. This implies del m by del y is not equal to del m by, it is del x.
If they were equal, then we would have said the given differential equation is said to be exact. Otherwise, it is not said to be the exact differential equation. Hence, it is said to be non-exact differential equation. Now, our job is to convert this non-exact differential equation into exact differential equation, so that integrating factor will help us to convert that differential equation.
Okay, now, so we will verify del m by del y is not equal to del m by del x. Consider the difference, let me take consider del n by del y minus it is del n by it is del x, that is equal to first value 3y square minus it is y square. This gives us only 2y square.
Now we can easily verify or examine.
This is a single term. These are the three terms. This is a single term. Single term with single term, where y square you can remove
and you can leave the function. You can leave the term on the right side only in the form of x, but in the absence of y. Therefore, you can call that resulting term as function of x alone, so that integrating factor you can consider.
Therefore, that should be taken as this is equal to, let one divided by n, we take the help of this n quantity, one divided by n ln by del y minus of it is ln by del x is equal to 1 divided by y square into x into 2 times it is y square. Then this y square cancels. It is 2 divided by x. We will call it as function of
x alone. It is not function of two variables. It is function of x alone when we divide the difference which is taken and it is divided with respect to n.
Okay, that is 2 by x is that, then it will be function of x alone. Then we consider the integrating factor. Consider the integrating factor as I of is equal to e to the power integral f of x dx. Here it is plus sign. Integrating factor with respect to x is with plus sign.
Integrating factor with respect to y is with minus sign. If you take the difference as it is,
then this is equal to e to the power integral, that is 2 divided by x into dx, that is equal to e to the power, it is 2 times log x, it is e to the power log x square, it is x square finite. So that I of is equal to only x square. I of is equal to x square means, then we will consider multiply equation 1 by I of, multiply equation 1 by I of to convert to exact ODE. Exact ODE. Then, so what is that term? Exact ODE. The term will be, that is x square multiplied to x square plus y cube plus 6x dx and plus x square into y square x dy equal to 0.
So this equation I claim, this becomes the exact differential equation after simplification.
X to the power of 4 plus x square y cube plus 6 x cube dx and plus of, that should be x cube y square, it is dy equal to 0. Then you have to write the solution, but to verify del m by del y only with respect to y means, that is equal to 3 times x square y square, and del m by del x equal to 3 times x square it is y square, both the values are same, that is del m divided by del y is equal to del m divided by del x. Okay, that is said to be exact. That is said to be exact. Then the solution, then the solution is given by, then the solution is given by integration of this term, okay, x to the power of 4 plus x square y cube plus 6x cube, it is dx, and plus of integration terms free from x. Here no term is there, 0 you write, dy equal to constant. Therefore, x to the power of 5 divided by 5, x cube y cube divided by 3, only with respect to x, keeping y as constant, and 6 by 4, x to the power of 4 is equal to, directly I am writing c2, because left side this term gives also constant, and combining these two, I will write it as c2, otherwise some capital A. Therefore, our solution finally, x to the power of 5 divided by 5 and 6 by 4 plus of 3 divided by 2, x to the power of 4, this term, and x cube, y cube, and divided by 3 is equal to A. This is the final solution. But the constant value you have to calculate from the given initial conditions. At x equal to 1 and y is equal to 2. What is the value of A? You calculate. So that gives the complete solution when you write the value of the constant. X equal to 1, 1 by 5 plus x equal to 1, it is 3 by 2 plus x equal to 1 and y is equal to 2, that is 1 into y 2 to the power 3, that is 8 divided by 3 is equal to A. Therefore, A equal to what value? So, A is equal to 5 into 3 into 2. You write the LCM, 5 into 2 into 3. So, this is 6 and 2 goes, 5 threes of 15, 15 threes of 45, and 3 goes and 5 twos are 10 plus 8. So this becomes, that is 6 plus 5, 1, that is 11, and 5 plus 8, 1, 3, 13, and divided by, that is 30. Therefore, A is equal to 131 divided by 30. Then your solution will be, therefore, required solution. Therefore, required solution is given by, required solution is given by x to the power of 5 divided by 5 plus 3 by 2, x to the power of 4 and x cube and y cube divided by 3 is equal to 131 divided by 30. So, this is what the final solution, this is general solution. This is particular solution.
Why we call it as general solution? Because the presence of arbitrary constant. Why we call this one as a particular solution? Because the particular value of the arbitrary constant we have calculated with the help of given initial condition. So again we will study this type of problems in the remaining two methods.